Okay, here we are again. Welcome. We are at the beginning of something. What's happening here is, if you recall, we are talking about how to have a program choose a path, essentially. How do we have the program execute some code sometimes and other code other times? Okay, so we're doing that with a conditional statement. A conditional statement involves saying, if this condition is met, then execute the lines of code in between the open and curly closed brackets. We can see an example of that running over here, which we built in the last video. I dressed it up with a little bit. There's now a white line over here to show us where the mouse is. If the mouse is over here, it's less than 100 pixels, and it is not executing that code, which draws a red background. But as soon as I move the mouse over, as soon as I move, click in the window and have it in focus and move the mouse over, we can see we now get a red background. No red background, red background. No red background, red background. Our program is doing something different each time through draw based on a condition. This is how everything works. You're programming Pong. If the ball hits the paddle, then change the ball's direction. If the ball goes past the paddle, change the score, et cetera, et cetera. This is what we're doing. We just want to be able to set conditions and execute different code based on those conditions. Everything you do is going to be sort of thinking through and designing that logic. So that's the beginning of this. There are a few more pieces that we want to get through. For example, what if we were to say, okay, well, I want to draw another line. I want to draw a line that's a little bit further over. And it is at 200 pixels. Let me run this now. And so, okay, 200, and that's a little mistake there. I want also the top of the line to be at 200 pixels. So here we have black background. Here we have red background. Here we have red background. What if I want a third option? Black to red to say blue. So I know I could say, if mouse x is greater than 200, draw a red background, a blue background. Bleah. So I think we're going to have that program working out. Black, red, blue, depending on where the mouse is. Black, red, blue. Here's the thing. What is going on here? There are two different cases. If the mouse is greater than 100, execute this code. If the mouse is greater than 200, execute this code. But we're actually testing both of these. We're actually drawing a red background and we're drawing a blue background. What if we had something different where instead of drawing a background, we want to draw some rectangle? So let's just say, let's make a red rectangle and we'll put it somewhere on the screen. And we will here, we will draw a green rectangle, and we will put it a little bit lower down, and that's going to be way off the screen. Okay, so what's going on here? No rectangle. Red rectangle, add the green rectangle. No green rectangle, no rectangles. But what if I want the green one to appear here and the red one to disappear? In this case here, let's say the mouse is at 400. If the mouse is at 400, it's greater than 100 and it's greater than 200. So we're going to see the red rectangle and the green rectangle. There is another way we could start to make this code work slightly differently. What if we want to exclusively only execute one of these? What if we want to say this? Else, if mouse x is greater than 200. Now, this looks similar if the mouse is greater than 100, if the mouse is greater than 200. If the mouse is greater than 100, else if the mouse is greater than 200. We can think of this else if as the word otherwise. If. Hate this video that I'm making right now. I have to just keep going. A little tired today. Let's just, this is gonna be fine. I'm gonna remake all these anyway. Okay, come on, we can do this. Okay, if the mouse is greater than 100, otherwise if the mouse is greater than 200. The thing, what's important here? There's something important here that we're totally missing, that I'm missing saying. The thing that's important here is with this structure, else if, with this structure, if, both of these can happen. With this structure, else if, only one of these can ever be executed. The interesting thing is, this is a huge mistake we've made here. Pause the video. And, okay, well, don't pause it yet. Wait. Take a look at this. Something is horribly wrong. Syntax is fine. It'll run, process won't give us an error, but we're going to have a problem. Pause the video and think about that, and then come back. Okay, you're back. Let's go over here and put that code in. So I'm going to say, else if the mouse x is greater than 200. So I've revised this code. So, okay, the mouse is about 50 pixels. It's not greater than 100, it's not greater than 200, it's just we're not seeing any rectangles. Okay, the mouse is now greater than 100, we're seeing a red rectangle. That's what we expected to see. I think I'm supposed to stand here. I'm supposed to stand here. It looks better when I stand here. Actually, this should be a little bit over, and this should be a little over, but whatever. It's fine. Now, the mouse is red rectangle. Now we move over here. What's happening? The mouse is greater than 200, but there's no green rectangle. Well, why is that? All right, well, let's think about it. Let's say for the moment, what happens if mouse x is 150? If mouse x is 150, this is true. So we execute this code. We don't execute this code. With an else if, we could, the first thing we find to be true, we leave. If mouse x is 250, let's say 250 is greater than 100, execute this code. We leave. We're done. I don't like this down here. It should be up here. Not that that matters. Okay, what happens if I make this 200 and I make this 100?
All this weird logic stuff that you're stuck thinking about all the time. Let's make this 200. Now, this is like 7 minutes already. This is a disaster. This should be like a 3-minute video just going over what else if and else is, but oh well. This is my life right now. Okay, here we go. Okay. Mouse X is here. Now I've got a green rectangle. Now I've got a red rectangle. Green rectangle, red rectangle. Why? Because when it's 250, we're executing this code and skipping out. When it's 150, this becomes false. If this is false, we can check the next one, and the next one is true, and then we skip out. With else if, when you have an if statement joined with an else if, you only ever do one of these. And we could even go so far as to say, else if mouse x is greater than 50. Right? We can join as many of these as we want. So let's go over here and add that in. So we're going to say, let's start with like 500, 400. Let's just keep adding more of these in. You can see we can have a whole bunch of these. 300, 300, 200. And we can have different colored rectangles at different locations, all arbitrarily, with different sizes, and all, well, let's see what happens now. So, oh, and you know what? This was nice having these lines there. So let's add all the lines so we can see where all this stuff is. Let's add a line at 300 and one 400. And 100 doesn't do anything anymore. Or maybe it does, or we need a line of 500. Ugh, this video is a disaster. I have to remake these. You know, I haven't really thought this through yet. I should do these after something or whatever. Ugh, I'm very tired today. This is not going right. These are all like a mess, and it's all in the wrong. Everything's wrong. The x values should all be the same, so they're spaced out. Whoa, what's going on here? This pixel makes no sense. This weird, strange, like blinking rectangular design that we've made. What's going on? The point that we're emphasizing here is that what we're doing is with this if statement, we are creating a set of possibilities, only one of which can be executed. So first we see if we're greater than 500. If that's not true, we see if we're greater than 400. If that's not true, 300, et cetera, et cetera. This is essentially the kind of logic you want to start programming if you want to create rollovers, essentially. We've created these regions that when the mouse is over them, something happened. Something you might try to do as an exercise right now
because this video so clearly explained all of this perfectly. And I also missed a whole important part, which is like what else is, because there's an else. I should just start this over, but I'm not going to start it over. I'm just doing this. Dang it. Tripping on things. I think I knocked one over. Oh. You know, there's a door here I could just leave. See you later. Okay, folks. In the hallway, look at me like I'm crazy. Because I really am. It's just like totally insane. Okay. This is fine. It's going to be a long video. Later, these are going to be shorter. I'm going to be redoing all of these anyway. Everything's okay. We're calm. We're fine. You're listening. You probably turned this off by now. If you haven't, you really lost your mind if you're still watching this. Okay. What are we talking about? The exercise for you. Well, okay. Here's your exercise. Here's your processing window. Divide it into four quadrants and have the quadrants highlight whenever you move the mouse over them. So the mouse, I guess in my drawing, the mouse should be here, that's a mouse, and this is showing that it's highlighted. So as you move the mouse over, create these regions of rollover. It's very similar to what we've done over here. The only difference is, instead of these sort of horizontal regions, these vertical lines sectioning them off, you've got to section the screen off in a grid. Now, here's what we kind of didn't say. With any if statement, we can also have an else.